More than 100 public health advocates are calling on Facebook to pull the plug on its new Messenger Kids app. The group sent a letter yesterday to Facebook CEO Mark Zuckerberg. It says, quote, a growing body of research demonstrates that excessive use of digital devices and social media is harmful to children and teens. Jerika Duncan is here with the experience of one Florida family using the app. Jerika, good morning.
Good morning. Everything in moderation. Facebook says it created Messenger Kids to give children a safe way to video chat and send messages to their friends and family. It features stickers and face filters geared for kids under 13 years old, an age group critics say is simply too young for social media.
Kindergartner Isla Thomason has been using Facebook's Messenger Kids app since it was released in December.
You can, like, do other stuff on your face, and it's a really good app for kids.
The six-year-old's father, Brett Thomason, signed her up.
This is the world that they live in. She's coming into this world. She needs to be prepared of how to communicate.
Thomason, a technical coordinator at a charter school in Sarasota, Florida, likes the fact that parents control who their children can talk to.
That even creates a safer environment than traditional text messaging, that all you need is a phone number and you can send a message to anybody and there's no blocks or anything with that.
Messenger Kids has to be set up through a parent's Facebook account because children under 13 still are not allowed to have their own. The app, which was created with the help from child development experts, has no buttons for sharing, commenting, or liking posts. A Facebook spokesperson told CBS This Morning, "We continue to be focused on making Messenger Kids be the best experience it can be for families."
Really what it's doing is indoctrinating much younger kids onto social media when their friendships should be offline and face-to-face.
Josh Golan, executive director of the Campaign for a Commercial-Free Childhood, says elementary school students should not be exposed to the harmful effects of social media. He cites studies linking it to increases in depression, suicide rates, and body image issues.
We wrote this letter because Facebook is the world's largest social media company, and by them going after young children and trying to get them on social media, it's going to be a game changer.
What responsibility do the parents bear?
The parents bear the responsibility ultimately, but as a society, we have a responsibility to make parents' job easier to raise healthy children and to look out for all children.
Josh Golan feels so strongly about keeping children off social media that he took the Wait Until 8th pledge, which encourages parents not to give their kids smartphones until the 8th grade. Mm-hmm. Golan told us he'll probably make his 9-year-old daughter wait even longer than that.
I like that idea, wait till 8th grade. Does anybody remember the old days where you'd get on a bike and go to your friend's house or gas, pick up a phone and call and say, hey, Jerika.
I do remember
those
days.
Want to go play?
Yeah. And it's important. I asked the six-year-old, what other activities do you like to do? She said, I do like to go outside, gymnastics. So I think it's a balance because the future is here.
Yeah.
These kids have access to all kinds of, you know, social media networks.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Parents just have to monitor it.
Yeah, but
more than ever before, that's all.
But when you go out to a restaurant and everybody's sitting at a table with other people like this,
that's so including the kids, Norah.
Yeah.
Including the kids.
Yeah, well, where do you think they learn it from? They learn it from their parents.
Oh, stop. You sound like my kids.
But I'm in league with them, Jerika.